this program, it was supposed to be a supplementary feeding center. It means that we have to supplement what the mother and the father is giving to the child in the home. Because we noticed that after our visits to the mothers and fathers in their home, they don't give them nutritious food. We call them families, but I wonder if the word family really applies to this. Because many of these families have got single mothers, the mother only. The father is not around here. So the mother has to look after their babies and their children. And mostly they are from very poor families. Now, if I take you to any of these homes, you will not find a kitchen. And so once there is no kitchen, how can she serve the food? So we try to help the mother by providing this food to her children. And we have improved the social situation because we have spared her some money. She had to spend on feeding the children, but we are doing that now instead of her. So we spared her some money, which she can use for other purposes, buying medicines or a piece of cloth to the children. What we noticed is that the children and their families are very poor. They are mainly displaced people who came from war zones due to civil conflicts. And I want to tell you now that many of the children, they look in good health now. And this is mainly due to the fact that we gave this supplementary feeding. Because this lentils is very nutritious to children, the lentils, the rice, and on occasions, very rare occasions, we also can give some fruits if we have like bananas. The health of the children now is much better and less prone to diseases because of the service we are giving to the children. So let us call it a supplementary feeding, but and now the other 2 days the mother, or the other 3 days, the mother should give something to the children from the money she has worked with. And also, to inform you, we have appointed a nutritionist from the university in Sudan here to look after the service of the food, to teach the mothers how the water should be boiled, how the cups should be cleaned, what is the quantity that it should be put in the milk so that it doesn't do any harm to the children. Then when there is a school around here, our medical team comes to the school. So the mothers, they know the days in which this medical units come. They send their children to that center if they are sick as well. So there is also the chance of medical center. I think the rate of mortality, those who would have died, would have been much more than this now. Because of the medical service we are giving, because of the food we are giving, because of the love, the water, we are sustaining their life. And I want to tell you that it's known fact that the number of deaths in Sudan among children is very high. And we have for sure reduced that number or improved that that figure by the service we are giving. And above all, I want to tell you, John, that these places are very hot places in summer and they need water. So we have the well, and we have supplied the center to the, we supply the water to the center. And we have told the children that when they come in the morning before food, they should wash their hands. And after food, they should wash their hands. So this is all improvement in the social system of the family. Mm-hmm. This center is a social center for them, not only a feeding center. They come, even as the Gabriel said, on Friday and Sunday, when it is supposed to be closed, they still come to the center. Hi. The Sudan now is passing through a very difficult time. We don't know our future even, but still, in spite of every obstacle, every difficulty, we are determined to continue the service. And when the instructions come to close the center, it is what you call a knife in our heart. We feel so down, so sad, but there is no way because there is no money. And what is the money we are talking about? What is the money? It is 35 cents per child per day to feed a child, which is nothing. A cost of a Coca-Cola or a Pepsi-Cola or a soft drink is about 10 children. But let me tell you something. I always want to insist on this. We are doing this work. Many people call it is good work. I thank them for that. But it is good, and the thanks should go to the donors. Because without the money of the donors, without the support of the donors, without the understanding of the donors, we would not have done anything to these children. We might have had pity on them, sorrow for them, but we don't have the money. You have provided the money, especially from Austria, and that's on behalf of these little children. Allow me to thank you very much. My plea, continue helping us.